Hey YouTubers, thank you for watching my second video, my second vlog on my adoption story. One of the most interesting questions that I got a lot of was, hey, what's it like to be adopted? And that's a tough question. It really is. Because there's a lot of emotion. And there's a lot of history when you think about being adopted. And what I mean by that is growing up knowing that I was adopted, my parents made sure that my other brothers and sisters treated me like everyone else. You know, I was yelled at when I needed to be yelled at, punished when I needed to be punished, hugged and nurtured like everyone else. It's no different than if you have natural born children. The only difference is that someone else basically conceived me. Growing up knowing that you're adopted, it means to me that one, I'm unique, I'm different. Different in a sense that I know that for some reason or another, I hold a special position in my family, in the sense that while I am a part of the family, I knew that I'm still different. It's hard to explain. You just know that, okay, these are my brothers and sisters. Yes, they are. I love them to death. And even today, I will say this proudly, I will lay down my life for them. That's how much I love them. But I know that in the back of my mind, they're still not my blood relatives. Did it matter? No, not really. It didn't matter at all. Because to me, my eldest brother was still my eldest brother. My eldest sister was still my eldest sister. And I loved them the same. Likewise with my youngest sister, all the way to my other siblings. I'm very thankful that, you know, I wasn't treated any differently. Because I think if you would treat that person, the adopted child, with like more preference than the others, then that would create some kind of resentment and jealousy, and that's how problems start. But in my opinion, my parents made sure that we were treated the same. I remember growing up, knowing that I was adopted, I remember the curiosity of me wanting to know, hey, you know, who do I look like? Do I look like my biological father? What were they like? Those type of questions always crossed my mind. And I would ask my mother and father, hey, you know, what do you remember about them? And they would tell me, you know, and that was reassuring to me, because that told me that they had nothing to hide. You know, I've seen some families that, you know, talking about adoption or the adoption of their child, you know, it's like a no-go zone. And I'm not sure why. I'm not sure why a parent would be afraid. To me, if you have nothing to hide, if you love your kid, you know, why not tell them? It's their right to know. I mean, in my situation, especially, I didn't ask to be born. I didn't ask to be put in a situation that I was in, where I'm left in the hospital, no one's coming to see me. I didn't ask to be adopted or any of that nonsense, but irrespective of that, you know, my parents gave me the benefit of the doubt and sharing with me, hey, you know, this is your mother's name, this is your father's name, you have two other siblings, you know, your mom was having a hard time, you know, we raised you, we love you, you know, that to me was important. That to me was very important. I hear stories of children, adoptees, finding out in their late 20s or 30s that they're adopted and they're traumatized by it because they're not told at an early age, so that way they're ready for it, that, hey, listen, you are adopted. But you know what? We're going to be open and honest with you. And I'm thankful for that, growing up with that type of environment. You know, I remember, you know, asking, and my mom would say, oh, yeah, your mom, you know, she was short, just like, you know, like similar to your height, and, you know, you sort of look like your father, and from what they remember. And it was important for me. It really was. And I'm very thankful for my parents for being very open about it. However, later on, they inadvertently planted that seed that would say that basically led me to go, you know what, I need to know about my biological family. I need to know who they are. I need to know more about myself. I really do. You need to discover yourself. And I think it's important for any adopted child, any adoptee, to discover themselves. I don't mean in the sense of, hey, what's my heritage, or what's my blood type. No, to discover, hey, this is what my biological family is like. These are my siblings. This is who I talk like. This is what we think alike or not alike. This is what we believe. Things like that. You know, was it a mistake for them to tell me about my biological family? I don't think so. To me, that's my birthright to know. It's my birthright to know. I wasn't, you know, and some parents, adoptive parents, may disagree, but you have to understand several things. Adoptees didn't ask to be born. They didn't ask to be born in the situation that they were in. And they didn't ask to be adopted. They were chosen to be adopted. It's very important. That's the key thing to understand. So, again, that's my opinion. That's just what I think. And it's the same thing. I didn't ask to be born. I didn't ask to be adopted. I was chosen. But I'm very thankful to have been chosen. I am very, very appreciative that I was given the life that I was given. And to this day, I think to myself, if I died today, I would die knowing that, you know what, I had a good life. I really did. My parents, my brothers and sisters, I cannot complain. I really can't. And I love them very much for that. I really do. Growing up, knowing that, you know, they were loving me like everyone else in the family, that's the exclamation mark, if you will, on the word family. But again, you know, my curiosity planted a seed, if you will, for conflict in the future. But again, I'm thankful. I cannot complain at all. Anyways, sorry for sorry for that. Peace.